We are going to revise about 100 dresses too that we were doing yesterday. A short overlook over this chapter. And then we will have the MCQ questions from the sample papers. Okay. So in 100 dresses too, what we have studied that the entire class was in chaos. Then the teacher, Miss Mason, she has clapped her hands in order to draw the attention of the class. Okay. Then what happened? You people will tell me side by side rather. Okay. She has read? A letter. Whose letter it was? By Mr. Pentronsky, who was Vanda's father. And what was written in the letter? Yes, she's saying that no more holabalak, no more funny names now, and nobody would make fun of anybody. And the entire class was silent. Okay, then afterwards, what happened? Then Maddie was most disturbed because of all this that has happened, and she was thinking of what to do now. Then what they thought, Maddie and Peggy, what they thought? Yes, they thought to write a letter. To write a letter to Vanda. And what they thought to write it down? They wanted to apologize it for their behavior. Okay, but actually it ended up in only a friendly letter. Okay, they have written only a friendly letter in which they wanted to tell her that she has won the drawing competition and to appreciate her drawings, and that it was unexpected on their part that she would win the competition. And later on, what has happened? They have written the letter, and as they did not know the address, what they have written over it? What they have written over it? Please forward. Okay, please forward. Okay, and they also went to Boggins' side, but they did not found. Okay, so then when they were waiting for the letter and the reply of the letter was not there, ultimately Maddie came out the idea that she would go to Boggins' side. And moreover, Peggy had also come out with an idea that she would go to Boggins' side. They both decided, they started early in the morning, and ultimately after going up to the mountain where they have reached the place where Boggins' side was situated. What kind of place it was? It was dismal, okay, very sad sort of place. The, you can say, rough passages were there. And moreover, here and there could be seen tufts of grass. Tufts of grass could be seen here and there. And ultimately they have bunches of grass, okay, handful of grass could be seen here and there. And when they have reached there, they did not find anyone there. They have opened the backyard, but nobody was there. And around in the corner, nobody was there to tell them that where they have gone. And finally, they came back empty-handed. And next day in the school, what it was? It was the Christmas day. Okay, so during the Christmas day, what it was? Celebration. Okay, the entire class was decorated with the Christmas tree as well as hangings. Okay, Christmas hangings for the celebration, and it was announced as holidays. While coming back home, there was again, you can say, shining golden night with golden light, which was gleaming in the snow. Okay, and moreover, there were the shops, they were decorated with cornucopias. What are these? Containers containing different colors of candies. Okay, some hangings, and there were also in the, you can say, in the windows of the houses, there were also placed holly. What is this? This is a wood from any deciduous or evergreen trees. Okay, that is considered to be auspicious for Christmas Eve. So they have been placed there, and ultimately what is there? When they were coming back, so the teacher in the class, what she has read a letter that was from Vanda. Okay, they were surprised. They were filled with sadness as they have got the two beautiful drawings. Vanda has told them that she's doing very well in the new school, but the teacher there, she is not equalizing to Miss Mason. She is more loving towards her. Yes? Miss Mason. Okay, and then afterwards, the teacher has given the drawing of the green dress. Okay, with red trimmings to that of Peggy. and the blue dress to that of Maddie. Okay, so going back to home, she has pasted that picture to the wall, where this is a pink flowered wall. Okay, you can say covered with the wallpaper of pink flowers. Okay, so where little bit of that wallpaper was torn, she has pasted the picture there. And while she was looking towards the picture, her eyes were filled with tears. And while her eyes were filled with tears, she was continuously looking, and through the blurred eyes with tears, what she has seen, that in the picture there is a face of Maddie. Okay, she rubbed her eyes, cleaned her eyes, and with excitement she ran towards Peggy. Peggy, who was least bothered about the drawing that was given to her, it was lying onto the bed only. And then what happened? And she has told that, have you looked at the drawing? She said, no, I didn't look at the picture. She said, just look at the picture, and it was again the face like that of Peggy. So finally, they were filled with regret also. They were ashamed also of their act, and it was only Wanda who suffered a lot. She has always, you can say, suffered, and in this time also she left the school forever. Okay, so this is all about 100 Dresses 2. So what this chapter, it describes to understand the feelings of others, to be empathetic towards others. Yes, don't pick on anyone. Okay, and it is also highlighting the theme of bullying in the class. Okay, okay, so this is all about the chapter. Now let me ask you few questions, MCQ based questions. Okay, from 100 Dresses 1 and 2, right? So you people will tell me. I'm not going to speak the entire options. It is given by Dilpreet. So now the first one is, when Peggy asked Wanda questions in a mocking tone, how did Maddie felt? When Peggy asked Wanda questions in a mocking tone, how did Maddie felt? How she was feeling at that time? What kind of feeling? Happy, she was surprised, helpless, or she was embarrassed? Embarrassed. You should not wait for the options. Your answers should be ready. Okay, because we have discussed in detail. She was embarrassed. She was counting the marbles. Next, Peggy had invented the dresses game too. Why she had invented the dresses game too? Why? She wanted to please Wanda, to tease Wanda, or make fun of Wanda? Actually, she wanted to tease Wanda. Okay? Making a fun is her way of asking the questions. Actually, what she wanted? She wanted to tease Wanda. Okay? Next one is, Maddie's attitude towards Wanda was, what kind of attitude Maddie has towards Wanda? Yes. What do you say about Maddie's behavior towards Wanda? What kind of behavior Maddie has towards Wanda? Give one word to me. Maddie did not have rude behavior. Polite. She was not at all polite. Soft. She had little bit soft heart for her. Okay. Next. Maddie being herself poor. Dash being the butt of ridicule. She was dash being the butt of ridicule. What you can say? Liked, hated, or dreaded? Maddie being herself poor, dash being the butt of ridicule. What? Liked, dreaded, hated. Dreaded, she was afraid of butt of ridicule. That she should not be butt of ridicule means that she should not be mocked like that of Wanda. Okay, next. The word, what is the meaning of, what is not the meaning of embarrassed? So, shy, proud, ashamed, awkward, which is not equalizing to that of embarrassed. What is embarrassed? Embarrassed. shy. First of all, tell me, shy means embarrassed. Yes. Proud. Ashamed. Okay, awkward. Yes, then proud is the answer. Okay, next. Who is, okay, her absent-mindedness was caused by her. Why Maddie was absent-minded? Why Maddie was absent-minded while in she was doing the sums in arithmetic class? Because of lack of concentration, it was. Okay. Why did Maddie decide to write a note to Peggy? Why she decided to write a note? Okay, first of all, tell me, she lagged, what she lagged? Will? She lagged nerve, she lagged inclination, or she lagged earnestness? What she lagged? She lagged will? Will she had will to write a letter to Peggy. This is the reason why she started writing a letter. She lagged nerve, she lagged inclination, or she lagged earnestness? Honestness she was having. She lacked only nerve. Courage she lacked. Okay. Then, what does disguise mean? Disguise mean? What does this word disguise mean? Okay, find out. Conceal. And hide, don't, okay. Disguise means conceal and hide the real appearance. Okay, or cover the real appearance. These are three and this is not the answer. Okay, actually the question is which is not meaning disguise. This is what I want to come to you here. Okay. What is not the meaning of disguise? What is it? It means to conceal, to hide your appearance or to cover your appearance. And what is not the meaning? It is reveal. Okay, it is revealed. Right? Next is, in the whole school, Peggy was the dash. What kind of whole school Peggy was? If you want to fill it down, one of the famous, is the famous girl, one of the most beautiful girl in the school. Known personality, okay. Maddie's absolving Peggy of any wrongdoing here shows that, okay, leave this. Maddie's torn up note was meant for, to whom she has written that torn note? Maddie's torn up note was meant for, to whom she has written that torn up note? No, she has written it to Peggy. You people were saying, ma'am, हमें 100 dresses अच्छी तरह से आता, अब ये देखो. She has written a note, she then tore it down because she lacked the courage to hand it over to her. It was, yes, it was meant for Peggy. Question is in twisted form, so you don't get confused, please. Next is, Wenda Pentronsky was a young dash girl. What, which girl she was? Which, from which background she was? Polish background. No, poor and Polish. Poles apart. Polish. She was from Poland. Immigrant of Poland to America. Next. To Wenda's American classmates, her name seemed. Why awkward? What are the two reasons why she was made fun of her name? उसके नेम को लेके क्या टू मेन कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स हैं? She has big and unique name. Yes, lengthy you can say. Okay, lengthy. And it was awkward, strange one. Strange name she has. Now, Maddie does not ask Peggy to stop teasing Wanda because. Why? Because she? She had fear of losing friendship. She is scared. She is timid. She lacked the courage to speak. Okay? So this is the reason. Yes, you can say. Next is, tell me which statement is not true. Nobody knew exactly why Wanda sat in the last row of seats. Was it true? No, nobody knew that why she is sitting in the last row. It is specially mentioned in the chapter. Wrong. Peggy had many clothes and her hair was curly. This is true. Because nobody talks to her. Everybody makes fun of her. She's not saying anything to anybody. This is the reason why she's sitting at the last. Okay. Wanda had many friends at the school. False. Jack Bagels won the contest for boys. This is also true. So, what do you think are true to Wanda? Okay, suppose this question is in this form. She was simple-hearted. I'm telling, cunning, mean, lazy, and innocent. So which are the qualities of Wanda? Simple-hearted and innocent means 1 and 5. It means, for example, cunning, clever, lazy and mean. This is mean. Okay. So, for example, options will be given 1, 2, 3, B option 1 and 2, like this. You have to choose. Okay. Next one is, who won the drawing contest for girls? Who won the drawing contest for girls? No, none other than it was Wanda Petrowski. Okay. When Peggy asked Wanda questions about 100 dresses in a mocking but polite way, Maddie felt again the same thing. How she felt? She felt embarrassed. She was afraid. Okay. Maddie felt that Peggy was not callous. What is the meaning of callous? Callous. Rough, rude it is. That Peggy was not callous because she used to protect small children from bullies. Right, very good, bullies. Its answer is bullies. Okay, now next is, what kind of girl was Maddie? 4 options are given to you. She was introvert, extrovert, guard, and fearful. What is introvert? Yes. And what is extrovert? Who is open to all. And she is guard or fearful? Guard. Maddie was guard. Okay. How was Maddie feeling? When you can say Peggy was making fun of Wanda. She was feeling cheerful, excited, upset, or melancholy? Upset. What is the meaning of melancholy? Sad. Sad it is. Sad and upset. No, they are not one and the same thing. Sad and upset is not one and the same thing. No, upset means you are perturbed, you are disturbed, you are agitated. Sad means you are in sorrow. sadness lead to, you can say this, disturbance. Huh, but like na, if you have options, then what you will choose? You have only one choice. This is what, these are complex type of MCQs. Okay, complex means where you feel like one or one, more than one options are right. But you have to choose the appropriate. Aapko lagega ye bhi theek hai, ye bhi theek hai. But what you have to choose the right one. Okay? This is often, you can say, this is often giving, you can say confusion for you people. It was upset. Maddie found it difficult to stop Peggy, focus on her work, stand in defense of Wanda and convince Peggy not to harass Wanda. What she finds difficult while she was sitting in the class. Okay, let me give you a hint. Maddie found it difficult. What she find difficult? Stop Peggy. She found it difficult. Second one is stand in defense of Wanda. Yes, she was finding it difficult. Next is focus on her work. This is also true. Then convince Peggy not to harass Wanda. Yes, this is focus on her work because all the four options are otherwise right. You will see in which context it is asked. Okay. What had Peggy not considered? What Peggy had not considered? That they were harassing Wanda. They were being mean, they were insulting Wanda, or it was bad manners. That they were insulting, they were harassing, they were insulting, they being mean or having bad manners. That they were harassing Wanda, she was not at all ready to accept it. What she is saying, that when Maddie said, "Now why you are asking this to her?" She said, then why she is always telling she has 100 dresses. I said to you, it will look that all the four options or more than one options are correct. But you have to find the most appropriate ones. It needs to have deep understanding of each and every line of the chapter. It was just because they never felt that Peggy was never feeling she was harassing Wanda. What she was thinking, she had insult to bahut dur ki baat thi na uske liye. She was not at all thinking about this. And moreover, what about being mean? She never thought. Okay, and have bad manners? This she has never thought. Answer is this, harassing Wanda. Next is, what is the meaning of this phrase, stood by silently? Stood by, now see the options given. You will again feel that more than one is correct. Stood by silently. Stood by silently, what it means? Did not interfere. They have asked in general, ignored it, kept quiet, or waited for her turn. Give me the answer now. What is the meaning of this phrase to what it means? Did not interfere, ignored it, kept quiet. Earlier you were saying waited for her turn. That was wrong. See, if you will look at stood by silently, according to you, you people will say, ma'am, ye bhi to theek hi hai, did not interfere. What I'm saying, you will feel more than one correct answer is there. But you have to choose the most appropriate one. Okay? Okay? Huh? What is the meaning of this phrase? Stood by silently. Next is, who had won the contest in girls, Wanda, and who has won the contest for boys? Okay, give me the name of the boy who won the contest. Wrong. Okay, with J, what J? What should I write here? No, I won't give the option because you people say, ma'am, hamein. Now you have seen from the book. It is Jack Bagels. What was the name of the teacher? Okay. What was the name of Vanda's father? Give me the name. Right? Don't. I, Jan Petrosky. Okay. Right. Next is. What is the meaning of stole a glance? Stole a glance. I'm writing here. If I won't give you the options, what is the meaning of this? Stop it now. Not at all. Absolutely wrong. What is the meaning of stole a glance? Wrong. This was given in the chapter. Now let me give the options. Now, write it down in your notebooks. I'm not going to give the answer. You people will tell me tomorrow. Note it down, please. I'm going to ask you now. I'm asking you now. What according to you? First, okay, let me take it down and tomorrow we will see what is the answer. Okay, so only through these 10 to 12 questions, what moral lesson you are taking away today is to have good English for solving MCQs also. Okay, I already told you that not only the outline or the summary of the chapter is necessary. You should know each and every word given in the chapter. Stare. What is the meaning of stare? Huh? What is the meaning of stare? Yes, right. Look casually. So you will tell me what is the right answer. Okay. Tomorrow we will see, and tomorrow we will have more practice of chapters, and moreover we will have of writing skills also. Huh? Kya? Tomorrow we will do from this and Nelson Mandela. That's all for today.